Now, inshallah, we will discuss bleeding time. Bleeding time, again, significance at first definition. Time elapses from pinprick of skin till stoppage of bleeding without clot formation. The materials used in this experiment. As we did this bleeding time by many, many methods, for example, by IV method, as we noticed, by IV method, and also by DOC method and by what we call modified DOC method. We will start by the first one, which is IV method for estimation of bleeding time. We need a sphygmomanometer. We need a stopwatch. We can't work without stopwatch as we measure time. We need disposable lancet, not used before. We need sterile swab. We need filter paper or soft tissue like this to remove blood. Yes? And of course, we need patient or volunteer. Please, we can, yes? Yes? Raise your, this part. As we noticed, bleeding time and clotting time. Bleeding time and clotting time shall be done for what? To estimate certain bleeding disorders. Bleeding time mainly measures what we call capillary or vessel function, then also use platelet function. When we want to do IV method, we should apply at first sphygmomanometer cuff. Where, as imagine as you measure blood pressure, sphygmomanometer cuff. Now, confirm it is working. Yes, it is now open. Yes, mercury opened. Yes, then sphygmomanometer cuff will be applied on the middle third of the arm like this. Yes, not firm enough. Not firm or not loose. So suitable like this. This sphygmomanometer cuff. Then we close. Yes, yes. Rest his hand on the table like this. Yes, be relaxed. Be relaxed. Then we raise the blood pressure till 40 millimeter mercury. Just before raising this, why? Why we raise the blood pressure till 40 millimeter mercury, less than diastolic? Why? To make standard pressure in the capillary. When I examine bleeding time in this person and the other person and third person and the fourth person, I put capillary under certain pressure, which is 40 millimeter mercury. So the result will be standardized. Yes, standard for all these persons. So we raise the pressure. Here we have a look here for the sphygmomanometer cuff. It is graded from 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 millimeter mercury. We raise the level of mercury till 40, like this. We emphasize it is closed. It is more than 40. We will decrease it till 40, like this. Then leave it till 40 millimeter mercury. Again, why we make it till 40 millimeter mercury? To keep the pressure in the capillary to be standard. Now, what can we do? Now, we should clean the part here, which you will examine. Area here on inner aspect of the arm, forearm like this. Area clean of or devoid of any obvious vein or capillary. Yes? Then leave this alcohol to be evaporated and to dry. Then, by the use of the disposable lancet here, please confirm that the disposable lancet, it is new one, not used before. Also, just before using anything, confirm stopwatch is working. Now it is working, so stop it and make it zero like this. So, This disposable lancet, is new, as we notice, not used before. Now we can open it, and on area clear from any vein or capillary, just one pin prick like this. Yes, and stopwatch should work. Now stopwatch worked. And every half minute, we should remove this blood by filtering paper like this. No compression should be done, but only just remove any blood formed. Wait for any more blood to appear. And just remove by the filter paper like this. Till stoppage of bleeding. Now still blood come out. One person said to me, I read that IV method done by tapping three times, three points, three different. This is another method for doing. But we should use three stopwatches at this time. And we at everyone stop bleeding, stop this stopwatch, and then take the average of the three. But now we use only one pin break. Other persons said that no pin break, but you should use sharp object to make one centimeter length wound with depth 1 millimeter. This is another method. And as we notice, even any small or minute amount of blood appear should be removed to give no time for clot formation to occur. Till stoppage of further bleeding, try to find if there is also more bleeding. Don't compress the wound, just touch the blood. Now I think it is clean. So now we can stop the stopwatch. Now it is 1 minute and 58 seconds, around two minutes. 2 minutes. So in this case, it is normal or prolonged breathing time. We did this experiment to identify whether it is prolonged or shortened. Prolonged breathing time may be from 2 minutes up to 9 minutes. So I think it is within the normal range. Imagine with me if by this method we find the bleeding time 15 minutes. In this case, or in such a case, we say prolonged bleeding time. What are the causes of prolonged bleeding time? Many causes. But as we say, by the use of bleeding time, we examine what? Platelet function. Vessel wall function. So prolonged bleeding time means that there's a problem in either vessel wall, like vasculitis, like deficiency of vitamin C, like what else? Like what we call Henoch-Chinoline purpura. It is a type of purpura in which there is a problem in the vessel wall. Also, if there is a problem in the platelet count decrease. Less than what is the normal platelet count at first, to say below what? Normal platelet count from 150,000 to 400,000
per microliter,
or per cubic millimeter. So if platelet count decrease below 50,000 per cubic millimeter, it is a state of thrombocytopenic purpura. Sometimes we found the platelet count at normal or even increased, but in such a case there is prolonged bleeding time. In this condition, there is abnormal platelet function, which is called thrombocytopenic purpura. In very important condition or disease called von Willebrand disease. In von Willebrand disease, which is a deficient von Willebrand factor, which is a factor present stored in the platelet and synthesized from the vessel. So this factor may act as a clotting factor or may help platelet function. So its deficiency causes both prolonged bleeding time and prolonged clotting time. So vulnerable disease here also causes prolonged what? Prolonged
bleeding
time. This is the first method, which is called IV method. To revise, we need what we call a sphygmomanometer. We apply pressure till 40 millimeter mercury, stabilize it at 40, then use disposable lancet. Yes, pen break, then stopwatch should work. Then by filter paper, we remove blood every half a minute. Till stoppage of bleeding. Now stop watch should be stopped and it is bleeding time. Another method for doing bleeding time is called DOC method and the modified DOC method. What is DOC method and what is modified DOC method? Have a look here for this pictures. Make sure it is modified, it is DOC method. What is DOC method? It's the lobule of the ear. Lobule of the ear, yes? We can use what? We can use glass slide. And we can use glass slide, yes, behind the lobule of the ear, yes, to stabilize this part. And by the disposable lancet, we pinprick this lobule of the ear firmly. Then stopwatch should work. Then, every half a minute, we remove the blood by filter paper till stoppage of bleeding. This is what we call Duke method. Yes, but simply it is painful. So we will do what we call modified Duke method. Modified Duke method, as we notice, Duke method is painful and sometimes shameful for especially females. So. Modified DOC method we can do by pinprick the tip of the thumb. Yes, the same. We need what also? We need sweat like this, sterile sweat. Sterilize this tip of thumb just before using. Yes, like this. As we notice here, you should wait for this alcohol to dry. Then use another disposable lancet. Sterile disposable lancet. New one also. Confirm that stopwatch zero. Yes, and it is good working. Try to find it is good work. Yes, it is good working. Good working. Make it zero like this. Then now it is dry. What are the materials used for doing modified DOC method? We need what we call a sterilized disposable lancet. We need sterile swab. We need stopwatch. Yes? We need patient or volunteer. So, buy the disposable lancet, pinprick the tip of the thumb like this. Stopwatch should work now. And use filter paper to remove this excess blood. Don't leave blood. If you leave blood, blood will clot. And the bleeding is stopped by clotting. Yes? We don't need blood to clot.
Right.
So, every while any minute amount of blood appear, remove it.
Wipe it.
Yes. Remove by this filter paper. Yes? Every time. While the stopwatch working. Yes? Every time. Please have a look. Many factors affecting doing bleeding time. The force by which you been pricked, whether the arm or the tip of the thumb. You may sometimes to be hesitated. So you will break. Minute injury will occur. Another one may be aggressive.
Deep
wound will occur and more time will take to heal. Yes? So we can't depend much upon bleeding time. Many other methods can be used now. And
The values, normal values, have wide range, as we say, from 2 up to 9. Yes? From 2 up to 9 minutes. Every time any small or minute amount of blood shall be removed. Now, we try to find if there is more blood appear. I think now no blood. So, bleeding stop. So, now we can stop the stopwatch. What is the time of bleeding time by this modified DOC method? It is 1 minute.
46 seconds.
Yes, 46 seconds. What is the value by this other method? I think
that was 1 minute and 58 seconds.
Yes. So there is variation. While the same patient, but the maneuver is different. The bend break is different. The area is different. So if I repeat it again, me and the same patient, but another method. A more new one result may appear. So there is a wide range for normal bleeding time. What is the main significance of this test? Again, if prolonged bleeding time, for example, yes, more than 15 minutes, it indicates what?
Prolonged bleeding.
Prolonged bleeding time. What are the causes of prolonged bleeding time again? What are the causes of prolonged bleeding time again? Like impaired platelet function, low platelet count. Impaired platelet function is called thrombocytopenic purpura. Low platelet count, thrombocytopenic purpura. Function, thrombocytic purpura. Vascular defect is as Henoch-Schönlein purpura. And the last one, von Willebrand disease. Let's go to the last part of this lab, which is clotting time. Clotting time. When we say bleeding time, it is the time elapses from pin break to the stoppage of bleeding without clot formation. Now we need clot to be formed. So it is the time elapses from pin break to the stoppage of bleeding with a clot. We need clot to be formed. So when we want to define coagulation or clotting time, it is the time elapses from what? From pin break till stoppage of bleeding with clot formation. Many methods can be used for doing this, what we call clotting time. One of these methods is rough method. Not give accurate measures, but it is common one to be used. We need what we call disposable syringe. We need glass test tube. Non-heparinized, of course, non-heparinized glass test tube. We need patient or volunteer. We need stopwatch. So again, a stopwatch should be zero. Yes? Zero. Then, we take blood sample from the patient. I will say it roughly, and we will do the last one to save time. This method, by using the syringe, we have a superficial vein. Take 1 milli blood, not add anticoagulant. We need blood to clot.
Clot.
Then we put the sample in this glass tube, non-heparinized. From having the blood sample, stopwatch should work. Yes?
Yes.
And every half a minute, have a look for test tube and just tilt it. If in a sign of fiber formation, it means clotting occurs. Now, stop. Watch should be stopped. Then read the result. But if no fiber appears, wait for another half a minute. Yes? Repeat the process. No fiber occurred, half a minute. Till sign of fiber occurs. By this method, clotting time may reach 6 minutes. Yes? So by this rough method, if for example it is 12 minutes, so it is prolonged clotting time. By bleeding time, we discuss the function of the platelet, number of platelet, the function of vessel. Clotting time, we discuss or examine the clotting process, clot formation. So when I said prolonged clotting time means there is deficient clot formation, there is deficient in any clotting factors. One of these, and one of the most important one, is von Willebrand factor. Von Willebrand factor decrease in von Willebrand disease, causing prolonged clotting time. So von Willebrand disease characterized by prolonged bleeding time and prolonged clotting time. As a causes of clotting factor deficiency, liver disease. Yes, vitamin K deficiency. Hemophilia. So Berbera is a good example for prolonged bleeding time, while hemophilia is a good example for prolonged clotting time. Yes, this is the first and one of the most common methods to do clotting time. The next one, which is doing clotting time by capillary method. By capillary method, normal range of clotting time from 5 to 15 minutes. How it is done? The materials used, we need capillary tube which is non-heparinized. Non-heparinized capillary tube, like this. This is a non-heparinized capillary tube. About 10 centimeter length and diameter of 1 millimeter. Yes? Non-heparinized. If it is heparinized, no clotting will occur. So should be non-heparinized like this. To compare with the capillary tube of hematocrit failure, which is heparinized. Yes? So the capillary tube for this experiment should be non-heparinized. Then we use also what? Sterile swab. We need disposable lancet. We need a stopwatch, we need patient. So, can we start now by this method? Yeah? Now, we can do it here. And also, while doing this experiment, we don't need one capillary tube only, we need multiple ones. Why? I will discuss. So now we have disposable lancet, yes, sterile swab, and we will clean this like this. Then remain for some time for this to dry. After become dry, we will use the disposable lancet. Disposable lancet not used previously. We need also stopwatch, which is zero. Yes? Then, now it is dry. Then, by bend break, we'll break the tip of the thumb like this, and just about the tip of the capillary tube like this, yes, 2/3 of the tube, another one, and I will say why, and so what should start now. Now, another one, and I will discuss why I take more than one. As you notice here, the amount of blood is few, so it is interrupted blood, no problem. Anyhow, yes. Now, every half a minute, we should disrupt part of this capillary tube and try to notice if any fibrin clot occurs. Please
after you do your work should remove the disposable lancet not to be harmful for you. Then every half a minute, now it is a minute, so remove part of this tube. Please remove part here and have a look for there is fibrin. No, still no fibrin. Can be separated like this. No fibrin, okay. So wait for another minute, half a minute. Every half a minute, disrupt the part of this capillary tube till you have a notice for fibrin to start to appear. If fibrin formation starts to appear, it means clotting occurs.
Clotting time.
And please keep parts removed here. And then another part. Fibrin? No.
No.
Leave one. After half a minute, we also distract another part. This is why we use more than one. As one capillary tube not enough.
Enough.
May need
to find the clotting time. Yeah,
maybe prolong the clotting time.
No, yes.
Yes? And please have a look. If you try to destroy this capillary tube, just distract and leave it and try to separate. Not destruct and remove rapidly. If you remove even fibrin present, will be destroyed.
Destroyed.
Yes. So now we can destroy it like this. This fibrin?
Little bit.
Not yet. I think fibrin starts.
Yes, yes, I think yes. Fibrin is shown little.
Fibrin not be full fibrin, yeah, to yes. Just small fibrin appear like this. Okay. Yes, like this. Mm-hmm. Small fibrins. If you wanted to confirm, wait for another half a minute. No problem. After half a minute, we try it again. By using this part is destroyed. Or simply by the stopwatch which we use, we can identify the time. Yes?
Of clotting time.
Yes. Then, distract another part. Again. Some fibrin?
Yes, now yes. It is.
Now, some fibrin appear. So now, we can
stop the
stopwatch. The time is
3 minutes and 41 seconds.
We can't do this by having a look for the stopwatch and they say the clotting time now 3 minutes and 41 seconds. Or another method to calculate the clotting time by the parts which we destroy. But it is a rough method. How? While we start to stop some time pass. Right. While we destroy and another time pass.
Based,
so the best one accurate is to have a look for the stopwatch. But anyhow, if in the exam one asked you, you have this, remove the bars. We distract 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the clotting time for this experiment? Now no stopwatch, but only the broken bars. Mm-hmm. You broke one, so you have
maybe
half a minute. You broke another one, another half a minute. Third one, another half a minute. So, 1.5 minutes.
1 minute.
Fourth one, another.
Yeah, 2 minutes.
Minute, two minutes. So, clotting time, if you have 4 broken parts, it is two minutes. And we said, clotting time from 5 to 15 minutes by this method.
Yes.
So, it has clotting tendency, more clotting tendency, more ability to form a thrombus formation. Yes, if it was done accurately. Yes, but as we notice here, it is corrupted. Few amount of blood appear. So not true enough experiment. To summarize again, what we did today, we did bleeding time by IV method, by DOC method, by modified DOC method. Then we did
clotting time
by the classical method. Then by what?
the capillary method. And we know that what is the significance of such experiment, whether bleeding or clotting time, bleeding time to examine the platelet function count and blood vessel or capillary function, while clotting time to examine what we call clotting mechanism. The last point in very minute few seconds, the best one today to identify bleeding tendency disorder is to measure the normal level of clotting factors. Clotting factor number one, for example, its normal value is 200 to 400 milligrams per deciliter. But you should know at least the normal level of factor 3. Why? Factor 3 or tissue factor normally not present in the blood. So its normal level is 0. Yes? The next one, to identify the fourth one. Why the fourth one? And the fourth one is the ionized calcium. What is the normal value of ionized calcium? It is from 8 to 10 milligrams per deciliter. It should be known. Whether in blood experiments or in general, what is the normal value of blood calcium level? Some textbooks said it is for, like this, from 8 to 10 milligrams per deciliter. Another textbook said it is 9 to 11, no problem. But not less than this. As blood calcium level, if decreased below 7, causes manifest tetanic. But if from 7 up to 9, cause what we call latent tetanic. Yes? Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.